are going to get started on our Romero Brito art project today. And I'm going to go with a fall theme. You don't necessarily have to do fall if you don't want to. But I want you to think about two things that you want to draw for your art project. So, because I'm doing fall, I've collected a leaf and an acorn. You could do, if you're doing fall, what are some other fall things that we can think of? Maybe a pumpkin, a turkey, all sorts of things that can go with the season. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at my leaf and I'm going to draw it. So I could just trace my leaf on the paper and that would be perfectly fine. But I am going to draw it because you might have chosen something that you weren't able to trace. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm looking at the top of my leaf here. And I see that I'm going to need to put a point at the top of my leaf. It's got all these little curves on each side. There's kind of like a V shape right here. And it swoops down. I'm following along the edge of my leaf with my eyes. Usually I would draw a lot lighter or press lighter with my pencil so that if I made a mistake, I'd be able to fix it a little bit easier. But I want it to be able to show up on camera well too. So I continue following along with my eyes. And I've just about finished half of my leaf. My leaf and add a few of the details on now that I've got the shape. So just like Brito, I've divided my object up into different sections so that I'll be able to put different colorful patterns in there. Now I also have my acorn, and I want to add that into the picture. So this is too small for me to trace, and it probably would not turn out if I traced it. So I want my acorn to overlap my leaf and be right about in this size right here. So I'm going to look at the different shapes. I see that the acorn has the little cap on the top of it, and that has a little bit of a curve on it. The sides come down in like a letter C curve. I'm going to erase some of my leaf lines so I'll be able to see my acorn a little bit better. so that's nice that I have two objects and I have a little bit of overlapping and a little bit of depth to it. And I think it makes it a lot more interesting. I'm going to decide if I want to outline with crayon, because I think I will be using a little bit of watercolor. If you don't have watercolor, just stick to your crayons, markers, maybe grab your color pencils. So I'm going to use my black crayon first, and I'm going to begin outlining. Brito used black paint and did outlines for much of his artwork too, and this helped divide up all the bright colors. Okay, I'm going to start with a combination of crayons and markers for one of my sections, and I need to think of a pattern that I want to use. I think I'm going to stick with the warm colors on my objects and use cool colors in my background. So warm colors are like red, pink, oranges, and yellows. So these are what I'm going to be using right now. I am going to start with some markers for my pattern. So I started with marker on this pattern, and I did some pink swirls, and now I'm coloring right over top of them with yellow crayon. Because it's lighter, it doesn't really affect the marker too much. I did go around the edge of the shape because I didn't want the yellow crayon to pull in the black wax that I outlined with the black crayon, and this helped my yellow to stay nice and bright. So now I'm going to keep going, and this time I think I'm going to use a combination of crayon and watercolor. So I want to do a completely different pattern, and it's going to be a little bit challenging. You have to think of patterns for each one of your sections. I have worked on several of my sections here, and I think I'm going to do a little bit of painting. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to put water on this section. It's okay if I go over top of the magenta color. I just want to stay inside my black lines so that my paint will stay where I want it to be. So I said I was using warm colors, so these are the colors right here that I'm choosing from. I'm going to see how orange looks. I've already wet my paint a little bit, And I've already wet my paper. Try to think of different creative patterns that you can do for each one of your sections. Here I had the marker and I went over it with water. And I think when that dries, maybe I'll draw another pattern right on top of it because it kind of lost my lines, but that's okay. I wanted to try something different. So here I'm going to draw first with a violet red crayon and make my pattern. And then I'm going to color over it with a yellow orange color. Get as creative as you want. This is a good time to take a break, and I'm going to let my paper dry. I just need to give my hand a little break too, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to do my background with some cool colors so that this leaf really stands out. Alright, now I'm going to work in my background. And I'm going to do basically the same thing, but this time I'm going to switch to cool colors because I really want my background colors to stand, or to make the leaf and the acorn stand out. So I'm going to use my black crayon and I am going to divide my background up a little bit so I have some different sections to do different patterns in and try out some different colors. You can make different sections like I am, or you could do one pattern for the background. It's your choice. And maybe one more right up here. So I'm going to use crayons, markers, colored pencils, and watercolors to make more patterns in the background. with your Romero Brito fall artwork, I want you to click on the slide that I've attached to the assignment. Make sure you follow the directions on the slide to take a picture of your artwork and turn it in. I hope you guys had a lot of fun and you came out with a very colorful piece of artwork.